there was an error in boardwork that I made on this slide here in front of me. The error is in where I put that block matrix in the larger k-bar matrix. Properly, if you look at those terms, ke1 soup 6-7 and ke2 soup 5-8, and look at where they come from. And in order to do this, let's just go back one slide. Okay, so now if you look at the way the elements and nodes have been written out for, or have been sketched out for this little assembly of two elements, you will note that the KE167 component is one that maps on to the global K bar AB block of the matrix. And the same holds for the KE2 soup 5-8 components, which are those two. Okay? They also map on to the global K bar AB block of the matrix. When we go to the block matrix K bar, what you will note that I've written them in the K bar BA position in terms of blocks. This just needs to be moved up here, which is the K bar AB position, right? It's the AB position because the rows are got from there and the columns are got from there. It's a bit of a squeeze the way I've written it because the K bar AA component turned out to be a little wider than I should have written out, but the important thing is that this block should appear right there. Okay, with that correction, which is an important one, of course, we also note that the same sort of thing may have happened with the block that we've written out here. Let's just check that. So we have KE163 and KE254. Let's go back and see where they come from. So KE163 would be the AD component, right? And KE254, when you look at this assembly of two elements, would also be the global AD component. That term, however, that block term, however, is in the right position, okay? And once we look at things in that light, we see that now this K-bar matrix is correct with this one correction, right? That block should appear in that position. With that, everything's consistent, and you can go ahead and program this into your code.